Hello, nice to see you all here. And so my today's topic is to tell how was deal in Buldur Technical School with this polycrop perennial plant plantations and our interest to get information as more out of it. The project went on from 2019 till 2022. So now when I'm looking back, I like to say this is a history before ChatGPT and other solutions which move forward all our needs and possibilities very fast. But I can tell you how far we get and what kind of results have and where to move forward. And so the first idea was to build the our plant collections and robot which go through the different plants, because in our collection we have more as 600 different taxons of ornamental plants, mostly for students to. Because Buldur is a horticulture school, and we think what all students which finish our school must to know all vegetables and fruit plants, but as well landscape plants. And you can use the herbarium or PowerPoint presentations, but most important is get to hands on them and plant and explore them on the site. And I was very sad because I know the school works and get information about plants 100 years, but nobody collect them. And so all information where we can find out which varieties don't grow anymore, about climate change, how plant tendencies going on, all this information is lost. And so we plan to the first to plant our beds, because there are we are in between the seaside and River Lielupe, and soil is very dry and poor. And we understand for good looking plants we need irrigation system, and we replant so all flower beds. There are, you see, the huge mess of different plants in all beds. There are 13 or 14 different plants, so they blooming all season around, and we put irrigation system. Because every plant have their own needs for water. We decide to plant the plants who need water more in the one circle, others which need dry conditions another. So we have 7 lines of watering of pipes, and we can water differently for needs of plant. And of course its system is connected with airport meteorological station, and clever enough to water more if dry conditions will be in next days, or hotter weather if it's higher as 25 degrees, it's watering 30% more. If it's too windy, it don't water. If predicts or was rain in the same day, it's don't watering. And we can water in the midnight, in the night when it's don't disturb students or gardeners. This is very nice, and so our plants grow. Bloom very good, but anyway some diseases appear and sometimes grow better and some not. So we still need information about phenotyping and appearing disease and pests. And our main goal, which we made together with three universities, Technical University, Agriculture University, and Latvia University, was the autonomous platform, which is which have some sensors for secure moving. But the main idea was cameras, RGB and multispectral camera, which take photos of the plants day by the day. So how things goes on? I think maybe it's can move forward yet. So it's driving. We have a databases, GPS bus system, and can make a marshrut. Okay, don't go forward anymore. And robot can stops in the exactly the place where we need, near the flowers. So he have a road to move forward from the plant to the plant, take photos. It's in the field. When the photos must be sent to the cloud or to the server, in our case, in the server, their process of analyze must go on, and when it come back with some solution. It was our main idea. We stuck in some places, so I don't. The 3 years for this all is a very short time, and I think we have a lot of to things to do forward. In the shame, it look very nice and understandable. Not so nice in middle of the robot. And of course, there are a lot of things what must be improved. But anyway, we together made our own robot, and it can collect information. And if we put it together with meteo information, I hope when we if we get the next project support, we can make platforms or system which we can add to another robots with other tasks. And our nursery sector looking forward very for this, because we know in the big crop fields with only one culture, it's difficult to predict or get information. But if you have no nursery with hundreds of different plants and hundreds of diseases and pests which can do some damage to your crop, it's more important. So the most important for this stage is get information, not only from 1 year, but for 3 or 4 for different growing stages, different seasons, put it all together to get a result, i.e. tool who can be who can help gardeners with solutions what to do in the in our nurseries to get healthier larger plants to get more to react faster if some problems appears as well in the first year. Okay, our irrigation going on half an hour in the spring, it's quite okay. The soil is moisture enough. In middle summer, something strange happens. Plants are wilting. Yes, our watering going on, and while gardener check all plants and find but in one middle of bed it's wilting, it's already late. and it's the damage for all season. But if our robot was ready in this moment and he can get information or some SMS before the damage happens. And the problem was very easy when the plants grow on and have a big foliage. We need more watering, and we prolong watering for an hour each night, and the problem was solved, of course. So we are proud of how far we are at this moment, as well as horticulture school, and we get that. But we have, of course, the plan how to move forward. Yes, and our wonderful databases for all plants of our collection. And as we know, for research we need repeats. And one, not all of plants planted in the six different places on our flower beds, but some 10. And it was very interesting what after the first season, when we collect all data and ask the same ChatGPT get out information, it was easier as to figure out from Excel. And we find what the same place, same hectare, but different beds, and the plants react, differ, and some of them grow faster, some of them bloom some couple of days or week earlier as another one. So there is a good place where to start to get more information and get idea why it is. As well, we detect diseases. To The first we must to know ourselves what kind of diseases we can find in this polycrop plantation. Afterwards, we can compare them with robot multispectral camera pictures and learn him to detect them. By the way, we find out some viruses in the ornamental plantings, except tulips, but we don't care about viruses. We don't have so hard lessons learned as bulb growers, but unfortunately we have in Echinacea plants, in Tsimicifuga, Anemones, cucumber, and tobacco rattle viruses. So we must be aware and rid of these plants before the virus spread around the another plant. So we have a way where to go, move forward. And if we start another, I don't put together so much big aims, because when you dive in one problem and another, you understand how many work is needed for some processes which on the paper looks very understandable and easy. But with each month and each year, now the situation changes a lot, and maybe nowadays we can find more fast and cheaper and easy manageable solutions as we have idea. Years ago, 6 years ago already. At this stage, we have a very good place where to make experiments and use different robotic solutions in our polycrop plantings. Collections, and our students are very proud of their robot and use it in everyday teachings and work. Robert Flux is very fun. And as we put cream on the our cake, we have a lighting system which in the night could make different wonderful shades of our garden as well in the winter time. I'm thinking about some experiments, how different LED lights have some to change, or is it have influence of plant development or not, but this is still ideas for the future. Thank you very much.